It's just a little bit of bite in Seamus Coleman's press conference.
Just on you doing the press conferences, Seamus, and then maybe you don't play, maybe you do. How difficult is that for you personally? I mean, you know, it's you're putting yourself up forward, and you know.
Absolutely not one bit difficult whatsoever. There's no ego with me whatsoever. I read something about me being disappointed at being asked or getting told to go to a press conference. The manager left me out of his first game. Had the decency to call me to his room and explain the situation, which I was fine with because Matt was playing very well at the time. There's absolutely no ego involved in me, and there never has been. And then to read that I was disappointed to be asked to go to a press conference when the manager had the decency to say, you don't have to do the press conference if you don't want. I know, you know, it might be disappointing because you're not playing, so if you don't want to do it, you don't have to. If you want to do it, it's fine. My duty as captain, my duty for the rest of the players is to be positive around the place, whether I play or I don't play. And I went to that press conference with absolutely no issues whatsoever. So it was actually very disappointing to read something like that about myself when I've got a character in the game that, you know, plenty of managers would back, and I think if you any other of my managers read that, I'd say they'd be like, that's a bit strange or that's a bit surprising. So that was disappointing to read, I have to say.
Right, that's very interesting from Seamus Coleman, because the actual headline in the Star newspaper was to humiliate, we can stick this up, to humiliate any player, never mind the skipper, in this way is truly unbelievable. And it was unbelievable because he wasn't humiliated, as we've just heard there from the horse's mouth. And that piece kind of went on to talk about how, you know, there was loads of different issues with Kenny at that point, and it was kind of a sign that he was really struggling at that point in his reign. Don't forget Seamus Coleman's demotion from the side in September for the opening game against Bulgaria, when he was deemed good enough to attend the pre-match press conference, even when he knew he was not starting the following evening. Imagine the response that Robbie Keane, Roy Keane, Andy Townsend, or Mick McCarthy would have given to any of their bosses had they been requested to attend a press conference, having been told they were not playing. I mean, I would expect that any of those men would have done their duty as captain and gone out and faced the media, because that's part of the role of captain. But I guess maybe Paul Lennon knows differently about how they would have responded. Coleman, ever the professional and at pains not to upset the camp or deviate from his commitment to his country, fulfilled a commitment he should never have been asked to go to humiliate any player, never mind the senior international side skipper and a player who is the most respected in the dressing room in this way, is truly unbelievable. Unbelievable, Jeff. Seamus Coleman came back pretty strong on that. Now, in fairness, this wasn't the first time we'd heard that this wasn't that there was a, you know, that it wasn't unbelievable, because I think the next day they had to publish something on the back of the papers. So we can stick the next one up here. This was David Snade tweeted this out. I just can't read the top of that one there. Maybe you can read the top of that. Oh, here, I've got it now. Having been labelled a peddler of misinformation by one experienced colleague and described as a sycophant by another in England for reporting the reasons behind Duff leaving the FAI and the senior players, including Seamus Coleman, support Stephen Kenny. This is interesting. Meanwhile, informed sources within the FAI have denied the claim in yesterday's Irish Daily Star that Seamus Coleman was asked by Kenny to carry out the pre-match press conference prior to the Nations League game with Bulgaria and Sofia last September. Instead, they say that Coleman insisted on performing the media duties, even though Kenny suggested that he could request another senior player to do so. Coleman already knew he would not start the game when he sat beside the manager in the Levski Stadium on the eve of the match. So what happened here was Coleman was told he was dropped, was offered the opportunity not to do the press conference, and like a man, like a captain, like a leader, he showed up and went, yeah, I'm going to do this because that's my gig. That's the gig when it comes to captaining your team, as opposed to, being humiliated or any of that kind of stuff. And it is interesting that there's this kind of background noise around management of Stephen Kenny, the pressure is ratcheted up on him, when it doesn't seem to be there from the players. It seems that stuff like this actually, maybe in a roundabout way, brings the players and management even closer together, because we all realise that Stephen Kenny is up against it. I just, looking through the paper today, obviously, it's in the Mirror, I think. It's been reported on OTBSports.com, and it's reported elsewhere. Those comments about the press conference, I'm just flicking through. Now, I'm obviously working from home today, so I'm working off some photographs of the stories. I can't see the bit in the Star today where they're reporting about the comments that Seamus Coleman made about the press conference just can't see it. I'm flicking through the paper today, and I've got a bunch of different other, like they're talking about him in captaincy, and they're talking about him in Serbia, and they're talking about you know, form of players, goalkeeping, last chance saloon, captaining through COVID, how he's determined to make up for lost time. I don't see him angrily lashing out at one of their columnists who said he was humiliated.